One of the things you might want to do is introduce lags to more accurately reflect the nature of the schedule. Looking at our simple schedule, we might say that there's a lag between the purchase of the hardware and the assembly of the hardware. That it takes 3 days after ordering the hardware for it to arrive to be assembled. This would be your classic finish to start lag. So how would I introduce this into the schedule? Well, there are a number of different ways. Perhaps the simplest is to double click the task, purchase, and then simply put in 3 days into the lag. Now, you could also, and then click OK, and you can see that that lag has now been extended and changed the start of the assembly hardware. Well, what about the other kinds of lags? Well, we go back, double click, and if we want, we just click that, and here you see you have the options for the three other kinds of lags. You just pick the one you want and then insert the time frame in the lag column, and the software automatically calculates and introduces it into your schedule.